It's my favorite time of the year, and for me, it's all about making batches and batches of homemade cookies. Today, I'm going to show you how you can make one big master dough and use that to make four different kinds of cookies with just a few minor variations. Let's get started. To make the master dough, I'm going to start with 2 cups of softened butter. I'm using salted butter for this recipe, along with some super fine sugar. Let's also add in some vanilla extract. Now, because I'm making a big batch of cookie dough, I'll be making it in my lifelong stand mixer, which is going to take care of all my mixing needs. I'm going to use the paddle attachment and the 5-liter stainless steel bowl, which is going to make the entire process a cakewalk, or should I say a cookie walk. Now, the best part is that I'll be giving away one stand mixer in partnership with Lifelong today. So for all the details, make sure you watch the video till the end. Let's cream the butter and sugar together until it's nice and fluffy. This looks good. Let's now add in 4 cups of all-purpose flour, that is maida. This Lifelong stand mixer is equipped with 8-speed functionalities. So you can start with the control knob at 0, where the mixer is turned off, and slowly increase the speed up to 8. Here, the planetary rotation of the Lifelong stand mixer makes sure that all my ingredients are combined well and forms a homogeneous dough. So the master dough is ready. I am now going to divide it into 4 different parts, each weighing about 250 grams. Now, for the first batch of the cookie dough, I'm going to make some thumbprint cookies. Just take some cookie dough and roll it out into balls, each weighing about 30 grams. Place it onto a baking tray lined with silicone mat or parchment paper. And then use your thumb to gently make an impression in the center. I am filling these impressions with some strawberry jam. You could use any filling of your choice. I am now going to bake my thumbprint cookies at 180 degrees Celsius for about 12 to 15 minutes. With the second batch of cookie dough, let's make some chocolate cookies. And for that, I'll start by making a slurry with some cocoa powder and some warm milk. Let's give this a good mix. And once it's nice and smooth, we can add it into our cookie dough and using a spatula, incorporate it properly. My chocolate cookie dough is ready. I am now going to roll it out into a thin layer of about 1/4 of an inch thickness between 2 layers of parchment paper. This looks good. I am going to first freeze it for about 30 minutes, and once it firms up, I am going to use a pizza cutter to cut it out into long rectangular pieces. I'm going to place these on a baking tray and bake them again at 180 degrees Celsius for about 12 to 15 minutes. Once these are baked completely, you could dip them in melted white chocolate and add some crushed white meringue on top. And with the third batch of cookie dough, I'm going to make Christmas cookie sandwiches. We'll start by adding a few drops of red food color into the dough. I'm using gel food color today. And then just mix it really well so that your entire dough gets a nice and bright red color. Once you actually roll the dough out like we did earlier and freeze it, you could use circular cookie cutters to shape your cookies. These look good. I'm going to bake them at 180 degrees Celsius for 12 to 15 minutes. Once the cookies bake and cool down completely, you could sandwich them with some cream cheese frosting, the recipe for which will be in the description box below. I'm also rolling each cookie into some shredded coconut. And for the fourth variation, we are making some spiced cookies. You can start by adding a few spices of your choice into your fourth batch of cookie dough. I'm using some cinnamon powder, some ginger powder, some crushed cloves. Into this, I'm also going to grate in some nutmeg and zest of an orange. Our spiced cookie dough is ready. Once you roll it out and freeze it, you could use a cookie cutter, like I'm using the gingerbread man today, to shape your cookies. Our cookies are ready for the oven. I'll bake them at 180 degrees Celsius for about 12 to 15 minutes. Once the cookies are baked, I'm going to decorate them with some royal icing. So all four variations are ready. I am now going to put them together into a Christmassy cookie box along with some other cookies and festive treats that I made earlier. I'll be sure to link all of these extra recipes in the description box as well. I had a lot of fun making all these four cookies using just one master dough and putting together this festive Christmas box. I'm also very excited about one of you winning this stand mixer. I leave all the details for the contest in the description box below, so make sure you check out the details and participate in the giveaway. I'll see you guys next week with another recipe. Until then, happy baking and Merry Christmas.